नमस्ते, माय नेम इज जेबीएन मनीषा सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी अंडर फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंसेस इन ज्योति विद्यापीठ विमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू सब्जेक्ट यूनिट ऑपरेशंस इन फूड इंडस्ट्रीज फॉर क्लास बीएससी एफएसटी सेकेंड सेमेस्टर एंड बीटेक एफबीटी सेकेंड सेमेस्टर। ओके, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑल अबाउट द grading and sorting of food. So let's begin with the topic. First we will discuss about the sorting of foods. So sorting and grading are the terms which are frequently used interchangeably in the food processing industry, but strictly speaking they are two distinct operations. Sorting is a separation based on the single measurable property of the raw material unit, while grading is the assessment of the overall quality of a food using a number of attributes. Okay, for example, sorting may be done on the basis of its color, its size, its shape, but grading is all about its color, size, shape, everything is come under the grading. Okay, so sorting may be regarded as a separation operation based on the differences in physical properties of food, raw materials, or products such as color, size, shape, or weights of the food raw material. Sorting is an important operation in controlling the effectiveness of many processes in food industry. For example, sorted vegetables and fruits are better suited for the mechanized operations for peeling, pitting, coring, or blanching. Food materials of uniform size or shape are better suited for efficient heat transfer during sterilization, pasteurization, dehydration, or the freezing process. Sorting and grading can both damage the food raw material or product because of improper handling of human operators, operator damage, dumping damage, or dropping of material, that means drop damage. Such damages can be eliminated or minimized by choosing effective process. So there are various sorting methods, which includes the weight sorting, shape sorting, size sorting, and photometric, or you can say it color sorting. So we will start with the weight sorting first. So weight is usually the most precise method of sorting. In the weight sorting, weight is usually the most precise method of sorting, and the weight of a unit food is a unit is proportional to the cube of its characteristic dimension, and hence weight sorting is more precise compared to the dimensional sorting. Okay, meat cuts, fish fillets, fruits such as apple, pear, and citrus fruits, vegetables such as potatoes, carrots, onions, and eggs are sorted by their weights using the spring-loaded strain gauze or electronic weighing machines. Devices incorporated systems into the conveying system. An alternative system is used to use the catapult principle, where units are thrown into the different collecting sections, and depending on their weight, a disadvantage of weight sorting is the relatively long time required per unit, and other methods are more appropriate with smaller items such as legumes or cereals, or if faster throughput is required. Size sorting, different types of screens are used for the size separation of the foods. Okay, so the screen designs commonly used in the food industry may be grouped into the two types: variable aperture screens using the cable, belt, roller, or screw sorters, etc. And second is there is a fixed aperture screens using the stationary, vibratory, rotary, gyratory, or reciprocating screens. Fixed aperture screens of a flat bed are used in the preliminary sorting of the potatoes, carrots, turnips, and multi-deck screens are used in the size sorting of cereals, nuts, and also partially processed and finished foods such as flour, sugar, salt, ground spices, and herbs. Drum screens are used for sorting peas, beans, and other similar foods capable of withstanding tumbling action in a rotating drum screen. Variable aperture screens with continuously variable apertures of roller, belt, or screw type find use in size sorting of the fruits and vegetables. Next type of sorting is done on the basis of their shape and is known as shape sorting. Shape sorting is adopted when food raw material contains undesirable material even after size or weight sorting and cleaning. Okay, for example, cleaned and size or weight sorted wheat may still contain wheat seeds of similar size and weight compared to the wheat. Shape sorting on the basis of a combination of length and diameter is useful under such circumstances. A disc sorter is used for shape sorting of wheat, rice, oats, and barley. And the principle is that the discs are cylinders with accurately shaped indentations, while will pick up seeds of the correct shape when rotated through the stalk, while other shapes will remain in the feed. Next type of sorting is the photometric color sorting. And photometric sorting uses optical properties of the foods to effect the separation of desired material from the contaminants. Okay, the goal is the separation of the items that are discolored, toxic, not as ripe as required, or still with hull. The color separator separates the fruits, vegetables, or the grains due to the difference in color or the brightness. And the color separators are generally used for larger crop seeds like peas and beans. And these seeds differ in color because of the varietal differences and also due to the immaturity or disease. Color sorters are also used for the color sorting harvested foodstuffs such as coffee, nuts, rice, and other cereals such as wheat or rye and pulses. Two photo cells are fixed at a particular angle with which direct both beams to one point of the parabolic trajectory of the grains. A needle is placed on the other side, which is connected to a high voltage source. When a beam falls on a dark object through photoelectric cells, current is generated on the needle, and the needle end receives a charge and imparts it to the dark seed. And the grains are then passed between the two electrodes with a high potential difference. Between them, and the seed is compared with the selected background or the color image and is separated into two fractions according to the color difference. And since the machine views each produce individually, the capacity is low. So the reflectance property are used to indicate the raw material maturity. For example, color of the fruit, vegetable, meat indicates the ripeness and the freshness. Next is the presence of the surface defect. For example, warm, cold cereals or nuts and bruised fruits. And the extent of heat processing, for example, manufacturing of the breads and potato chips or the crisps. Okay. So next is the other sorting methods. Sorting on the basis of the surface of roughness or stickiness may be used for separating seeds. In surface texture roughness separator, the mixture to be separated and is fed over the center of an inclined wrapper, belt moving in upward direction, and the round and smooth grains roll on slide down the wrapper at faster rate than the upward motion of the belt, and these are discharged in the hopper. The flat shape or rough surface particles are carried to the top of the inclined wrapper and dropped off into the another hopper. Next is the grading of foods. Grading is basically the quality separation on the basis of the overall assessment of the properties, which affects the acceptance of the raw material, of the food raw material for the processing and the finished food product for consumer acceptance and the safety. The grading factors which determine the quality of the food include the process suitability, consumer safety, and consumer acceptance. The grading parameters commonly used in food industry include the following size and shape as functional and acceptability factors. Maturity to describe the freshness of the eggs, ripeness of the fruits, and aging of meat. And texture to grade the crumb structure in bread and cakes. Crispness in apples and viscosity of creams. Flavor and aroma as indicators of ripeness of fruits as well as effectiveness of processing conditions. Okay. Then color is an indicator for consumer acceptability and effectiveness of the process. And blemishes such as cloudy, yolk, black spot, blood spot, and shell cracks in the eggs, bruises in fruits, and insect holes in coffee beans are the cereals to indicate their defect and impurity. Contaminants and undesired parts such as rodent, hair, and insect parts in the flour, soil, and spray residues on fruits and vegetables, microorganisms and their metabolites on meat, toxic metals in the shellfish, fragments in meat, bone fragments in the meat product, and pod residues in the peas and beans and stalks and stones in the fruits. And all these are the adverse quality of the raw food materials. Then the grading methods. Okay. Grading methods may be classified into the two types. Quality control procedure, in which the quality of the food is determined by the laboratory test on the sample drawn statistically from a batch of a food. And next is the procedures, in which the total quantity of the food is subjected to physical separation in quality categories, and the grading may be carried out manually or by the specialized machine. For proper grading, the food unit must be presented singly before the human grader or machine for assessment. These devices may be roller or vibratory tables or rotating wheels equipped peripherically with pneumatic devices, which pick up the food pieces and rotate them for viewing and then release them at a given signal. Manual grading is done by the trained operators who are able to assess a number of grading parameters simultaneously. For example, eggs are graded manually by the candling process. Machine grading is only feasible where quality of a food is linked to a single physical property, and hence a sorting operation leads to a different grades of material, but can be carried out by combining a group of sorting operations so as to separate the food units on quill it basis. Thus, wheat of a particular variety may be graded by combination of cleaning and sorting operations. Sometimes a single property may be helpful in grading the food. Thus, peas of small size are recognized to be most tender and of the highest quality, so that the size sorting of cleaned peas resulting in a quality grading. Peas may also be graded on the basis of their density using flotation in brines of varying densities. Similarly, potatoes are high density, desirable for manufacturing French fries, potato chips, and dehydrated mashed potato, and may be graded using rotation in brines. And mechanical grading is cost effective and efficient as well. Okay. So this is all about the grading. So in this session, we will cover the grading and the sorting. Two unit operations are covered under this session. For the exam point of view, questions may be asked like explain the different types of sorting methods and what is sorting, what is the need of sorting, and what is grading, what are the need of grading. Likewise, questions will be asked in your final exam, so prepare accordingly. I hope it is clear to all, and thank you so much for watching this session.